In this lecture video, we are going to talk about the second way of discovering requirements, scenarios. So why are scenarios so important, or why are they used? People find it, you know, usually easier to relate to real life examples rather than abstract descriptions of systems. They can understand and criticize a scenario of how they might interact with the system and so on. Even requirements engineers can use the information they have gained from discussions after giving a user a scenario, and they can use these requirements or this information to formulate actual system requirements. So what are scenarios? Scenarios can be particularly helpful for adding more detail to an outlined requirements description. So scenarios are descriptions of example interaction sessions. Each scenario usually covers one or a small number of possible interactions. Different forms of scenarios are developed, and they provide different types of information at different levels of detail about a system. A scenario usually starts with an outline of interaction. During the elicitation process, more details are added to this to create a complete description of that interaction. At most, this is what a scenario will include. First, a description of what the system is and what the users expect when the scenario begins. Second, a description of the normal regular flow of events in a scenario. Third, a description of what can go wrong, the exceptions, and how do we handle them. Fourth, information about other activities that might be going on at the same time. Last, a description of the system state when the scenario ends. Scenario-based elicitation actually work with stakeholders in order to identify the scenarios themselves. That is, when we use scenarios for requirements elicitation, first of all, we have to interview or talk to customers in order to define the scenarios themselves or identify the different scenarios of interaction. Based on this, we can capture requirements once we place these scenarios with customers. Scenarios may be text, they may be supplemented with diagrams such as screenshots and so on. Let us now take a look at an example of a simple textual descriptive scenario for a mental health care patient management system. So let's look at this. The initial assumption or the start state of the scenario is given here. The initial assumption is that the patient has seen a medical receptionist who has created a record in the mental health care system and collected the patient's personal information such as name, address, age, contact details, and so on. A nurse is logged onto the system and is collecting medical history and other patient information. This is the starting scenario of the interaction. Next, what are the normal flow of events for a patient healthcare system, mental healthcare system? First, the nurse will search for the patient by the family name. If there is more than one patient with the same surname, the given name, that is the first name, and the date of birth can be used to identify the patient. The nurse then chooses the menu option to add medical history. The nurse then follows a series of prompts from the system to enter information about consultation anywhere, that is in any clinic, the mental health care problems, the existing medical conditions, medication that the patient is currently taking, any allergies, home life, and so on. What can go wrong? So this is the normal sequence of events whenever you register a patient with a mental health care system. What can go wrong, or what are the exceptions that can take place? First, the patient's records do not exist or cannot be found. The nurse could create a new record and record the personal information. This is what happens in case the records cannot be found. So this is an exception, and also it includes what is to be done in case of an exception. Second, patient conditions or medications are not entered in the menu. This is an exception, or not the normal sequence of event. In case of this event, then the nurse should choose the other option and enter the free text describing conditions, medical conditions, as well as medications. Third, patient cannot or will not provide information on medical history. Again, this is an exceptional case. In this case, the nurse should enter free text recording patient's inability or unwillingness to provide this information. Other activities that may simultaneously happen with this kind of interaction. So you can see this entire scenario describes the interaction between the patient and the nurse. Other activities that can happen simultaneously with this interaction is record may be consulted but not edited but by other staff while information is being entered. What is the system state upon completion? The user is logged on. The patient record, including medical history, is entered into the database. A record is added to the system log showing the start and end time of this session, as well as the nurse who has been involved in collecting this information. So this is a snapshot or an example of what a scenario which contains only text description or textual information looks like. There could be other scenarios depicting diagrams, screenshots, and more other additional information. This is one way or another way of collecting requirements. The first one was interviews. The second one is scenarios. The third one, use case. So what is a use case? In the simplest form, a use case identifies the actors or the entities, the people or system involved in an interaction. Scenario just gave you a situation or an interaction, a form of interaction with a normal and abnormal sequence of events. But what a use case focuses is on the people or the systems involved in the interaction and also names the type of interaction. This is then also supplemented by additional information such as text, graphical models, and so on. So UML is usually the base, or it is used to represent a use case. We will talk about UML in the next chapters and modules. Next, use cases, as I told you, are documented using a high-level diagram called as the use case diagram. The set of use cases, that is the entire set of use cases for the complete system that is to be built, will represent all possible interactions described in the system requirements. Now, who are actors? Actors in the process may be humans or other systems and are usually represented as stick figures. Each class of interaction is represented using a named ellipse. Lines link the actors to the interaction. Optionally, arrowheads may be added to lines to show how the interaction is initiated. We will diagrammatically show how a use case looks like. There is no hard and fast distinction between scenarios and use cases. Some people consider each use case as a single scenario. Others would prefer encapsulating a set of scenarios within a single use case. Use cases identify the individual interactions between the system and its users or other systems. Each use case should be documented with a textual description. So let us look at use cases first. This is an example use case. As I told you earlier, use case contains actors, basically focuses on actors and the roles they play in interacting with the system. So you can see medical receptionist is an actor involved in the mental healthcare patient system. So you can see the receptionist is denoted by a stick figure. Now the receptionist will encounter or will talk to or perform this activities. So we can see that a class of interaction is represented using a named ellipse. Register patient is one scenario or one entire interaction, which we saw in the scenario way of in the scenario's example, the textual description, where a medical nurse is registering a patient. So you can see register patient is one class of interaction or scenario, and this is connected to the medical receptionist because a nurse is responsible or a receptionist is responsible to register a patient. A nurse or a receptionist can also view personal information that has been updated or entered into the system. Let's come to the nurse. A nurse can view the record of the patient. a nurse can also edit the record of a patient, and so on. So you can see medical receptionist and nurse are stick figures, which are nothing but actors or entities interacting with the system. These are the different classes of interaction. That is, a medical receptionist can register a patient. A medical receptionist can also view personal information. A nurse can view records. A nurse can edit records. Let's go to the other stick figures. These are health managers. These health managers can view personal information which has been entered by the receptionist, can also export stats, can generate reports and so on, but can nowhere register the patient or edit any information. Let's look at a doctor. A doctor is an actor who can view the patient record, the medical record. He can also add information to the record. He can also set up an appointment or set up a consultation with the patient. So you can see in this small example of a use case, 1, 2, 3, 4 actors are available, that is medical receptionist, manager, nurse, and doctor. The different scenarios or interactions that are defined here are register patient, view personal information, view records, edit records, set up consultation, export statistics, generate reports. The lines here represent links between the actors and the scenarios. So only when an actor is connected to the scenario, he can perform or be a part of that interaction. A manager is not connected to register patient, so he cannot perform that interaction or cannot take part in that scenario. So you can see here that use cases are used to identify individual interactions between the system and its users and other systems. Now, in this example, the actors are only humans, but actors could also be other systems, non-human systems that interact with the current system or the current scenario. So scenarios, which we studied a little earlier, and use cases, both are effective techniques for eliciting requirements from stakeholders who interact directly with the system. Each type of interaction can be represented as a use case. However, because they focus on interactions with the system, they are not as effective for eliciting constraints or high-level business and non-functional requirements, or for discovering domain requirements. These basically focus on actors and their interactions with the system. So in this lecture video, we have understood what are scenarios and how scenarios are helpful, because they depict a real life situation to the stakeholder. The stakeholder will behave in a real life circumstance or situation, and just by observing his inputs and how he responds and how he interacts with the system, a requirements engineering team can elicit requirements easily. We have also seen what are use cases and what are the different elements when we use use cases: the stick figures, the ellipses, the links which show interactions, and so on. We've also seen how use cases are not suitable for eliciting domain requirements or high-level business requirements, non-functional requirements, simply because the focus of a use case is an actor. Thank you.